Well, stay tuned to this episode because I'm going to talk about the 5 common things that you're doing right now that could harm your erection. So we're going to dive into it. So I'll see you in the episode. This podcast is for you, the modern man. I'm Dr. Ann Truong, your host. I'm an intimate health medical doctor and best-selling author of the book, Erectile Dysfunction Fix. I'll do a deep dive into sexual health and performance and how it affects men of all ages and backgrounds. So let's get started and be sure to visit my website at sexualhealthformenpodcast.com for more information and resources from the show. See you on the inside. Well, hello there. Welcome back. I'm Dr. Ann Truong, and today we're going to talk about 5 common things that you do every day that could really harm your sex life and eventually lead to ED. So let's dive in at this point. You're going to be so amazed because this is just something that you do every day, and I will hope that you will learn something from today's episode as well. So we're going to talk about nitrous oxide. Nitric oxide is a gas, and it is a critical component for the blood vessel. But the blood vessel needs nitrous oxide in order for it to relax and open up, so that way you have more increased blood flow. The endothelial cells and the cells that line the inside the blood vessels are the one that produces nitrous oxide. Now, if you listen to my past episode, I discussed how the endothelial cells are prone to injury due to inflammation, smoking, poor diet, and even cholesterol. So when it's injured, it cannot produce nitrous oxide. So there are 2 ways that the body can make nitrous oxide. It's from the food that you eat, and then it gets processed through the saliva. We'll dive deep into that a little bit later. And then an enzyme that is in your blood vessels that process the nitric to nitric oxide. Okay, those of you that can see this on the video, at around the age 40, you lose 50% of your nitrous oxide. Yes, because nitrous oxide gets less and less and less as you get older. And by the time you're at the age 60, you're at about 15% nitrous oxide as you were when you were in your 20s. So that's a bummer. And that's why we see more cardiovascular or heart disease as you get older. And when you have decreased nitrous oxide is what determines whether you have more blood flow or not. And that's why when you get older, you have ED, you have heart disease, Alzheimer's, stroke, heart attack. Nitrous oxide, when it's less and less, you have more a thickening of your artery, which is the blood vessel that brings in oxygenated blood to your cells. So when you have less nitrous oxide, the more severity, the more the stiffening of the artery, as you can see from this picture. So when you have less nitrous oxide around age 60, when it's about 15%, you get like plaque deposit that comes from the cholesterol that gets sticky to the artery, and that's what leads to blockage and eventually poor blood flow. And you'll see it more in the sexual organs first, because the artery to the sexual organs are the smallest one compared to the heart. And this is happening in both men and women. Now, I love this picture because this picture really shows clearly how we get nitrous oxide and what happens when we take it in as a food. So when you eat food that are high in nitrous oxide, such as green leafy vegetables like spinach, kale, broccoli, when you eat it, your saliva, which has bacteria in the mouth, actually processes the nitrate. So when the food goes into your mouth, it becomes nitrate, and then it goes to your stomach, and then in the stomach lining, the juice, the acid in the stomach lining converted from nitrate to nitrite. And then when it goes to your intestine, it is converted from nitrite to nitric oxide. And then the nitric oxide goes to your blood vessels, and that's where the endothelial cells convert it to nitric oxide. So that way your cells get absorbed and you have increased more blood flow to the organ. And just know that the saliva in your mouth is involved in processing the nitrate to nitrite, and then the acid in your stomach process the nitrite to nitric oxide. So that's why when you start taking a certain medication, it affects the concentration of nitric oxide, because you will disrupt the bacteria that is present in your mouth as well as the acidity that is in your stomach. Now, what causes decreased nitric oxide and eventually heart disease? Because when you have decreased blood flow, it not only affects just the sexual organ, but also affects the heart as well too. For instance, smoking, poor diet, a diet that's high in carb and processed food, it inhibits the enzyme that makes nitric oxide, which is nitric oxide synthase. A poor oral hygiene or oral infection, and then you take antibiotic, that will decrease nitric oxide. A sedentary lifestyle, you don't exercise at all. Inflammation can cause from free radicals, from the diet, as well as from the environment. Drug therapy, we'll go over which type of medication that will affect nitric oxide, and diabetes. And we know that in diabetic, they produce less nitric oxide in its perpetual cycle, because less nitric oxide will exacerbate diabetes as well. All of these conditions that I just mentioned all have decreased nitric oxide. Well, how much nitric oxide do you need in a day? You should be getting about 300 to 400 milligrams of nitrate. Remember, nitrate comes from your mouth. Your mouth formed nitrate to nitrate. So that equals approximately 4 milligrams per kilogram a day. And taking nitric oxide in that amount will actually lower your blood pressure. And a lot of the nitric oxide come from broccoli, cabbage, celery, lettuce, spinach, kale. Unfortunately, most of us can't get enough to meet our daily needs, because we're going to have to eat large servings of those vegetables that I just mentioned. And interestingly, organic vegetables have less nitric oxide than non-organic vegetables. The mouth bacteria actually help you convert the nitrate to nitrite. And so you want to be able to have a lot of bacteria that is in your mouth, because that help increase the nitric oxide concentration. Because studies have shown that in people that take antibiotic, they actually have less bacteria in their mouth and therefore less nitric oxide. And if once the antibiotics stop, then the bacteria colony is able to colonize the mouth again and the nitric oxide increases. So what to do to increase nitric oxide? Because we know that low nitric oxide, poor blood flow, right? Low nitric oxide, poor blood flow. High nitric oxide, good blood flow, all right? So things that disrupt or decrease nitric oxide production is antiseptic mouthwash. I do antiseptic mouthwash every day. Well, now I'm not going to do that anymore. Now that I find out that doing this will kind of kill the bacteria in your mouth. A bacteria in your mouth is the one that actually convert your food to nitrate. And then fluoride toothpaste. Fluoride toothpaste also antiseptic. You want to use toothpaste that is non-fluoride. Antacids. Common antacids such as Prilosec, Prevacid, Nexium, Protonic, Dexilant. Those are all proton pump inhibitors. And what they do is that they prevent acid from being produced in your stomach. And that actually decreases the conversion of nitrite to nitric oxide. So you don't want that. All right. You want to have the acidity in the stomach. And then we know that eating a high carbohydrate and processed junk food actually inhibits the enzyme nitric oxide synthase from converting nitrite to nitric oxide. Also, smoking. Smoking also decreases nitric oxide as well. So five things that you want to stop doing is stop smoking, stop using mouthwash, stop using fluoride toothpaste, antacid as much as you can, and improve your diet as well. Things that promote or restore nitric oxide production is being on a Mediterranean or a DASH diet with lots of green vegetables and less processed carb, moderate exercise, meaning getting your heart rate to at least 80% of maximal heart rate. I recommend either jogging or fast walking or even high intensity interval exercise. Infrared light therapy or infrared sauna increase nitric oxide, and taking a nitric oxide supplement. Now, I will leave the link in the show note on nitric oxide supplements as well as a recommendation for infrared light therapy. It will be a link down there as well as a link to the Mediterranean diet. Sunlight, 30 minutes a day will actually help as well. And not only does sunlight help with nitric oxide production, but also kind of reset your circadian rhythm and help with sleep. And then that eventually leads to the last point, sleep 7 hours a night as much as possible. Because when you sleep, that's when your body heals physically and also psychologically as well. So to recap, things that increase nitric oxide are eat a Mediterranean diet or a DASH diet, do moderate exercise, infrared light therapy or infrared sauna, nitric oxide supplement, and sunlight at least 30 minutes a day, and sleep at least 7 hours as much as you can. And having said that, now you know the 5 things that you shouldn't be doing that you're probably doing every day that is really harming your sex life, and you want to be able to restore and increase your nitric oxide content. So that way you have better blood flow. Not only will it help your performance in the bedroom, will also help your heart as well, and also longevity. So having said that, if you want more content and you want to have an opportunity to ask me more questions, I encourage you to check out the Modern Man Club. The link will be down below. This is the club where I will be coaching you and assisting you on how to restore your erectile capacity again. I'll see you in the next episode. Thanks for listening to the Sexual Health for Men podcast. If you love this episode, then please take a screenshot on your phone and post it on Facebook, Instagram, or wherever you post. And be sure to tag me and let me know why you like this episode and what you like to hear in the future. That will help me know what's great for you. And I would love to give you the most incredible free gift designed to help you improve performance quickly. Go to my website at sexualhealthformenpodcast.com to get the book, The 5 Common Costly Mistakes Men Make When Facing ED. I would appreciate it if you subscribe, leave a review on Apple Podcasts or wherever you listen, and just know that you can have sexual vitality for life. I appreciate you. Until next time.